Hi, everybody. We are Sunflowers and Red Feathers. I'm Kristina.
And I'm Steffanie. We are two moms living in the before and after of child loss.
And we are here doing our first introduction video for our podcast. So we just started out. So we thought we'd give you some information about ourselves to start off with how we met. So my son, Mason, died on August 1st, 2017. And Steffanie reached out to me on Facebook Messenger because she had just lost her son, Joshua, in March of the same year. So just 5 months before Mason. And we became fast friends. We were both new moms again. I think the first time we actually met each other, I had just had my son, Noah, and she just had her son, Caleb. And we went to a little local Denny's and had breakfast and just stayed in touch over the months. And now it's been about 3 years.
Yeah. So, when I first reached out to you, we were talking like for hours each day, just about everything, life. It was crazy. We were both pregnant with babies and it was hard and it was crazy. And she was my biggest support during that time.
And mine.
It was great. So we've been friends for 3 years now and we've been through so much. We've added more children to our families and it's been fun to have her friendship and her support. And I love it. A couple weeks ago, we decided to do a video and we talked about how to cope throughout the holidays with grieving and all of that stuff. And afterwards, a few people reached out to us and they were like, hey, you guys should do podcasts. And we're like, huh? Well, you know, that was fun. We could do that again. And so this has kind of blossomed into our little pilot program, Sunflowers and Red Feathers. Hers is Sunflowers and I'm the Red Feathers because both of those things mean something to us because of our boys. And so here we are, we're doing a blogcast. We have our Facebook page, we have an Instagram page, we have a YouTube channel, and here we are, we're doing our blog and we're excited to share our stories with you guys.
Maybe we should share why sunflowers and why red feathers.
I love that plan.
So my son Mason was 19 months old and when they asked what color we should do for his memorial service, I really had no idea. Like, he didn't have our favorite color or anything that I knew of. But my mom was his daycare provider, and she was with him pretty much every day for 5 days at least of the week. And she's like, he always grabs the yellow sippy cup. So we kind of just decided his favorite color was yellow, and that became like a representation of him in our lives. And we all wore yellow to his memorial, and still all the time. It says it as well on my shirt. But yeah, yellow is our color for Mason, and that kind of morphed into anything that reminds us anything yellow that reminds us of him. So sunflowers, obviously, in the summertime. He died in August, and so the next summer was his 1 year anniversary, and I just remember all along the freeway and all around our house there is these wild yellow sunflowers that were popping up everywhere. And to me that was just like a sign, or at least something happy that reminded me and made me think of Mason. So sunflowers kind of became our thing, our symbol for Mason.
Definitely. I love seeing sunflowers because it reminds me of him. I never got to meet Mason, but
yeah,
I always put that together. And I have red feathers. So I had a funny little five-year-old boy. Joshua was crazy about anything with Romans, soldiers, anything. And the Roman soldier armor, the helmet always had the little red, I don't know what it's called. I think it
looks like a mohawk to me.
Yeah, it looks like a mohawk, but it was red feathers. And so he would always draw the armor and always made sure to put the red feathers on top. And so when he was in preschool, they would always make paper hats. And he always put red feathers on his friends' hats that he'd make for them. And so that kind of became our thing. We have red roses. Red was his favorite color from like the time he was a baby. So everything was red. And so red feathers just kind of became his thing now. it was funny because after we had his memorial service, we ended up going to his preschool and all the kids made me hats. And it was the sweetest thing. And all of them put red feathers in the hats. And it was one of the most precious memories ever. So red feathers is for Joshua.
Oh, I've never heard that story. That's sweet. Yeah. Well, I wish we had live comments because somebody would be asking us what else they want to know. But is there anything else we should share? Well, besides that, we have, this video is going to be obviously on our YouTube channel, but we have Facebook, Instagram. The videos will be on our YouTube channel, but we're also going to post it to our blog. And I'm sure you've noticed that we are calling ourselves a blogcast, not just a podcast, because we are also going to be having a blog version of these videos. So if you can't watch them for whatever reason, you can always read like the outline version of whatever we talked about, or both. And so a blogcast is a thing apparently, and that's what we are, a blog and a podcast. So be sure to follow us on Facebook, or I guess like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and read our blog.
And share. Yes. There are plenty of moms out there that don't have the support they need. We're lucky to have each other and other friends that we follow through these pages and kind of things. So share us with your friends. And if you need that support, let us know and let us help you as well.
Yeah, we're happy to help in any way. So I think it's huge from my point of view. I remember feeling so unsure if what I was feeling in the beginning months was normal, and being able to reach out to Steffanie and knowing that she was feeling the same way was really helpful. So if you are seeking resources and you need help, by all means, follow us, read our blog and everything. But if you need more one-on-one help, please let us know, because we'd be happy to talk with you or at least point you in the right direction. So
exactly. We're here for that. And I mean, we know the heartache, we know the pain, but we also know the joy that can happen in our lives. And that's what we want to share the most.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. Well,
yeah, be looking out for a new video in the next, hopefully, week or so.
Yep. We'll talk to you later.
Bye.